Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. This time we are learning about the letter Ra. Before we started, I will read a little dua, which is Rabbi Zidni Ilman Warzukni Fahman, Rabbi Zidni Ilman Walhikni Bisolihin. The letter Ra is number one. Is actually there are four explanations about the letter Ra, but today or this time, this video, we will learn only 4 points, and the next one we will learn the other one. So if you like this video, please subscribe and share with your friends. Never know, maybe your friend will learn as well. Then inshallah, if you teach one person then about Al Quran or Kalamullah, Allah inshallah will reward you with 10 good deed or amal inshallah. Amin. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim is number one is a ra, so we pronounce it ra with fatha, with a line on top, or dhamma, which is looks like number 9 on top on it, should be pronounced with full mouth. That's where we say ra. It's not ra but ra. For example, fama rabihat tijara fama rabihat tijaratuhum. So fama rabihat tijaratuhum. So how we pronounce properly is ra. It sounds like there is wow at the next to it. So I will write it in here. It looks like this ra, like that. And that's from surah number 2, verses 16. And the next one is ra with dhamma. There's takfuruna billahi wa kuntum. So takfuruna billahi wa kuntum. That's from surah number 2 and 28, verse 28. The second ra is with kasra. Kasra is the line underneath. So fatha is the top, then kasra is underneath. Should be pronounced with an empty mouth. So the difference between ra in here, we say ra. For example, ra kasra is lakum inda bariikum. Lakum inda bariikum. So we don't say bari, but we say bariikum. That's from surah Al-Baqarah, verses 54. And another one example is kalam Allahi thumma yuharrifunahu. So kalam Allahi thumma yuharrifunahu. That's from surah number 2, verses 75. And the third one is, so we go from fatha kasra, now is we go for the next one is when a fatha or dhamma appear before raa saakin. Remember Raa Saakin with a little zero on top? The letter Raa Saakin will be pronounced with a full mouth. For example, so Fatha and Raa Saakin. Ayamin wakana arshuhu ala. Ayamin ayami wakana arshuhu ala. That's from surah number 11, verse 7. And the next one is dhamma with the sakin. Wa innaka laminal mursalin. Wa innaka laminal mursalin. That's what it is. Wa innaka laminal mursalin. That's from surah number 2, verse 252. And the fourth one is if a kasra, which is line underneath, appears before a Raa Saakin, the Raa Saakin will be read with an empty mouth. For example, tunzirhum la yu'minun. Tunzirhum, we don't say tunzirhum, but we say empty mouth. Tunzirhum la yu'minun. That's from surah number 2, verse 6. So that's our lesson about the letter from 1 to 4 at this time. Inshallah, next video we will learn from 5, how is Ra from 5 to 8. Inshallah, hopefully you learn something, we learn something from this lesson, this video. Inshallah, amen. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.